grant the souls of our hearts, by the inspiration of thy Holy Spirit, that we may perfectly love thee, and worthy magnify thy holy name, through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Our Lord Jesus Christ said, Hear, O Israel, the Lord our God is one, and thou shalt love the Lord thy God with all thy heart, and with all thy soul, and with all thy mind, and with all thy strength. This is the first commandment. And the second is like, namely this, thou shalt love thy neighbour as thyself. There is none other commandment greater than these. On these two commandments hang all the law and the prophets.
Lord, have mercy upon us. And write all these thy laws in our hearts, we beseech thee.
Almighty God, whose kingdom is everlasting and power in him, have mercy upon the whole church, and so rule the heart of thy chosen servant Elizabeth, our Queen and Governor, that she, knowing whose minister she is, may above all things seek thy honour and glory, and that we and all her subjects, duly considering whose authority she hath, may faithfully serve, honour, and humbly obey, in thee and for thee, according to thy blessed word and laws. Through Jesus Christ our Lord, who with thee and the Holy Ghost liveth and reigneth ever one God, world without end.
Amen.
In silence you. Merciful God, you have prepared for those who love you such good things as pass our understanding. Pour into our hearts such love toward you, that we, loving you in all things and above all things, may obtain your promises which exceed all that we can desire. Through Jesus Christ, your Son, our Lord, who is alive and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, now and forever.
Amen.
The portion of scripture appointed for the epistle is written in the second chapter of the prophecy of Jeremiah, beginning at the first verse. The word of the Lord came to me, saying, Go, and proclaim in the hearing of Jerusalem, Thus says the Lord, I remember the devotion of your youth, your love as a bride, how you followed me in the wilderness, in a land not sown. Israel was holy to the Lord, the first fruits of his harvest. All who ate of it were held guilty. Disaster came upon them, says the Lord. I brought you into a plentiful land to eat of its fruits and its good things. But when you entered, you defiled my land and made my heritage an abomination. The priests did not say, Where is the Lord? Those who handled the law did not know. The rulers transgressed against me. The prophets prophesied of Babel and went after things that do not profit. Be appalled, O heavens, at this. Be shocked, be utterly desolate, says the Lord. For my people have committed two evils. They have forsaken me, the fountain of living water, and dug out cisterns for themselves, cracked cisterns that can hold no water. Here endeth the epistle. The Holy Gospel is written in the 13th chapter of the Gospel according to St. Matthew, beginning at the 10th verse. The disciples came and asked Jesus, Why do you speak to the crowds in parables? He answered, To you it has been given to know the secrets of the kingdom of heaven, but to them it has not been given. For to those who have, more will be given, and they will have an abundance. But from those who have nothing, even what they have will be taken away. teach them in parables is that seeing they do not perceive, and hearing they do not listen, nor do they understand. But then indeed is fulfilled the prophecy of Isaiah that says, "You will indeed listen but never understand. You will indeed look but never perceive. For this people's heart has grown dull, and their earrings are hard of hearing, and they have shut their eyes, so that they might not look with their eyes, and listen with their ears, and understand with their heart and turn, and I would heal them. But blessed are your eyes, for they see, and your ears, for they hear. Truly I tell you, many prophets and righteous people longed to see what you see, but did not see, and to hear what you hear, but did not hear it." Thanks be to God.
Thanks be to God.
I believe in one Lord, Father Almighty, maker of heaven and earth, and of all things visible and invisible, and in one Lord Jesus Christ, the only begotten Son of God, begotten of his Father before all worlds, God of God, light of light, very God of very God, begotten not made, being in one substance with the Father, by whom all things were made, who for us men and for our salvation came down from heaven, and was incarnate by the Holy Ghost of the Virgin Mary, and was made man, and was crucified also for us under Pontius Pilate. He suffered and was dead, and the third day he rose again according to the Scriptures, and ascended into heaven, and sitteth on the right hand again in glory to judge both the quick and the dead, whose kingdom shall have no end. And I believe in every ghost, the Lord and giver of life, who proceedeth from the Father and the Son, with the Father and the Son together is worshipped and glorified, who spake by the prophets, and I believe one Catholic solid church. I acknowledge one baptism for the remission of sins, and I look for the resurrection of the dead, and the life of the world to come. Amen. The notices are very much just printed in the notice sheet, which is public. Please take it away with you. But it is also available on the website and on the Facebook page. Nothing really to add to the things which are there, except to say keep spreading the word about us being here, both physically and online as well. The only thing to say is that if anyone does, this is not to you here physically, and if you are watching online, if you have anything you would like prayed for, either at morning prayer or at Mass during the week, whether that's a thing, a situation, a person, please do let me know. Either drop me a text, ring me, or drop me an email. May I speak in the name of God, who is Father, Son, and Holy Spirit.
Amen.
I have a confession to make, which is that many years ago, I watched the Monty Python film, The Wife of Brian. My further confession is that I watched it again. I think I've watched it three times. There's a famous bit where Christ is on the mountain, the Sermon on the Mount, and they are mishearing him. Let's go to cheesemakers. And then there's the other bit, a little later, when Brian is running away and he encounters the hermit in his hole with his juniper bush. And the hermit in his hole speaks in riddles. He's completely potty. He's lost the plot. He's completely naked, apart from a very small and dirty loincloth, with a long beard looking like a cross between Dumbledore and Gandalf. and he seems to be speaking in riddles. It was a bit of a poke at the parables. What Monty Python was saying was, well, Jesus was speaking in riddles too. But he wasn't really speaking in riddles. In a sense, what he was doing was speaking in code. What he was saying in this gospel, as it were, was to give the disciples the means for cracking the divine enigma code. He was making it clear that these were the people who would understand what was being said. Later next month, Caridwen will get her GCSE results. The GCSEs, she didn't get around to sitting, thanks to COVID. One of the things that she struggled with, and she will not have a problem with eternity, because she is by far from being anyone, is maths. Our eldest niece, who works for Treasury, took first in maths from Durham. And Rachel would come round regularly, perhaps once every fortnight, for supper, and give Caridwen a maths tutorial. Caridwen once said, she couldn't quite get the phrasing right, but eventually, after a little bit of help, she managed to say that with maths, it seemed to go in one ear, sort of furtle around a bit inside, and then out the other. And in a sense, well, I know what she's talking about, but it sounds true with me. In a sense, that's also what Christ is saying about all of those who had heard the word of God beforehand. They heard, but not understood. They'd seen, but not understood. A bit like algebra. You can see it written down and not have a clue what it's all about. The word of God is different. The people before did not see and understand, did not hear and understand, because despite hearing the word from the prophets, they did not have the word of God with them. They did not have Christ with them. And that's what Christ is saying to the disciples. You understand, because you see the word. You understand because you hear the word directly. I'm giving you clarity of vision. I'm giving you clarity of hearing. You can hear God's message. See it, hear it, and live it. We've just heard God's word speaking to us, Christ himself. In a few minutes, we will receive the word of God in sacramental form. We break the bread and we break the word. We see, we hear, and we taste the world. We are given the message, we are given the insight of God's love for each and every one of us, not for us to keep it locked away in here, but to share. Love, you see, is completely and utterly worthless if we don't share it with others. If we don't share God's healing message, then it's no point in us receiving it. It's not a private thing, it is for all people. We receive God's word. We see it. We hear it. God gave us two eyes to see, two ears to hear. and one mouth to proclaim, and one heart to live. Amen. So let your light so shine before men that they may see your good works and glorify your Father which is in heaven. We pray in our own prayer cycle this day for the role and work of the United Nations Organization. In the wider church of bishops, priests and people of the Diocese of Northwest Texas, Benin and Bermuda. Within the Diocese and Prayer Cycle for the parish of St. Barnabas Southfields, for Ian Tatum and Joy Horse, the clergy. Pray for the whole state of Christ's Church militant here in heaven. Almighty and ever-living God, who by thy holy apostle hast taught us to make prayers and supplication, and to give thanks for all men, we humbly beseech thee most mercifully to accept our alms and oblations, and to receive these our prayers, which we offer unto thy divine majesty, beseeching thee to inspire continually the universe and church with the spirit of truth, unity and comfort, and grant that all they that do confess thy holy name may agree in the truth of thy holy word and live in unity and godly love. Lord, in thy mercy,
hear our prayer.
We beseech thee also to save and defend all Christian kings, princes and governors, and especially thy servant Elizabeth our Queen, that under her we may be godly and quietly good, and grant unto her whole council, and to all that are put in authority under them, that they may truly and impartially minister justice, to the punishment of wickedness and vice, and to the maintenance of thy true religion and virtue. Lord, in thy mercy,
hear our prayer.
Give grace, O Heavenly Father, to all bishops and curates, to Justin our Archbishop, to Christopher our Bishop, that they may both, by their life and doctrine, set forth thy true and lively word, and rightly and duly administer thy holy sacrament. And to all thy people, give thy heavenly grace, and especially to this congregation here present, that with meek heart and due reverence, they may hear and receive thy holy word, truly serving thee in holiness and righteousness all the days of thy life. Lord, in thy mercy,
hear our prayer.
And we most humbly beseech thee of thy goodness, O Lord, to comfort and succour all men who in this transitory life are in trouble, sorrow, need, sickness, or any other adversity, continuing to pray for Jones only. Lord, in thy mercy,
hear our prayer.
We also bless thy holy name for all thy servants departed this life in thy faith and fear, beseeching thee to give us grace, so to follow their good examples, that with them we may be partakers of thy heavenly kingdom. Remembering all who have died in recent days, including Ken Wilson, priest, and Lex Darling, and all whose anniversary falls at about this time, including Michael Bell. Lord, in thy mercy,
hear our prayer.
Grant these prayers, O Father, for Jesus Christ's sake, our mediator and advocate.
Amen.
Ye that do truly and earnestly repent you of your sins, and are in love and charity with your neighbours, and in intend to lead a new life, following the commandments of God, and walking from henceforth in his holy way. Draw near with him, and take this holy sacrament to your comfort, and make your humble confession to Almighty God, meekly kneeling upon your knees. Almighty God,
Father of our Lord Jesus Christ, maker of all things, judge of all men, we acknowledge and beware of our manifold sins and wickedness, which we from time to time most seriously have committed by thought and word and deed against thy divine majesty, provoking most justly thy wrath and indignation against us. We do have most serious and heartily sorry for these our sins, in remembrance of that which we have suffered us. The burden of that is intolerable. Have mercy upon us.
Have mercy upon us, most merciful Father.
For thy Son, our Lord Jesus Christ's sake, give us all that is past, and grant that we may ever hereafter
serve and please thee in minutes of life, to the glory of thy name, through Jesus Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Almighty God, our Heavenly Father, who of his great mercy hath promised forgiveness of sins to all men that with hearty repentance and true faith turn unto him, have mercy upon you, pardon and deliver you from all your sins, confirm and strengthen you in all ways, and bring you to everlasting life, through Jesus Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Hear what comfortable words our Saviour Christ said unto all that truly turn to him. Come unto me, all that travail and are heavy laden, and I will refresh you. Hear also what St. Paul said. This is a true saying and worthy of all men to be received, that Christ Jesus came into the world to save sinners. Lift up your hearts.
We lift them up unto the Lord.
Let us give thanks unto our Lord God.
It is meet and right so to do.
It is very right and our bounden duty that we should at all times and in all places give thanks unto thee, O Lord, Holy Father, Almighty Everlasting God. Therefore, with angels and archangels and with all the company of heaven, we laud and magnify thy glorious name, and for praising thee and saying,
Holy, 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 Lord God of hosts, heaven and earth are full of thy glory. Glory be to thee, O Lord most high.
We do not presume to come to this thy table of the blessed Lord, trusting in our righteousness, and made them, by his royal oblation of himself once offered, a full, perfect, and sufficient sacrifice, oblation, and satisfaction for the sins of the whole world, and did institute, and in his holy gospel command us to continue the perpetual memory about his precious death until his coming again. Hear us, O merciful Father, we most humbly beseech you, and grant that we, receiving these thy creatures of bread and wine, according to thy Son, our Saviour Jesus Christ's holy institution, in remembrance of his death and passion, may be partakers in his most blessed body and blood. Who in the same night that he was betrayed took bread, and when he had given thanks, he broke it, and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take, eat. This is my body which is given for you. Do this in remembrance of me." Likewise, after supper he took the cup, and when he had given thanks, he gave it to them, saying, "Drink ye all of this. For this is my blood of the New Testament, which is shed for you and for many for the remission of sins. Do this, as often as ye shall drink, in remembrance of me."
which art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those that trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, the power, and the glory, forever and ever.
Almighty and ever-living God, we most heartily thank thee for that thou dost vouchsafe to feed us who have duly received these holy gifts with the spiritual food of the most precious body and blood of thy Son, our Saviour Jesus Christ, and dost assure us thereby of thy favour and goodness towards us, and that we are very members incorporate in the mystical body of thy Son, which is the blessed company of all faithful people, and are also heirs through the hope of thy everlasting kingdom, by the merits of the most precious death and passion of thy dear Son. We most humbly beseech thee, O Heavenly Father, so to assist us with thy grace, that we may continue in that holy fellowship, and do all such good works as thou hast prepared for us to walk. Through Jesus Christ our Lord, to whom with thee and the Holy Ghost be all honour and glory, world without end.
Amen.
Glory be to God,
and
honour, peace, goodwill towards men.
We praise thee, we bless thee, we worship thee, we glorify thee. We give thanks to thee for thy great glory, O Lord God, heavenly King, God the Father Almighty. O Lord, the only begotten Son, Jesus Christ, O Lord God, our ever God, Son of the Father, that takest away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Thou that takest away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Thou that takest away the sins of the world, receive our prayer. Thou that sittest at the right hand of God the Father, have mercy on us. For thou only art holy, thou only art the Lord, thou only, O Christ, is thy Holy Ghost, our eyes and glory of God the Father. Amen.
The peace of God, which passeth all understanding, keep your hearts and minds in the knowledge and love of God, and of his Son, Jesus Christ, our Lord, and the blessing of God Almighty, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Ghost, be amongst you, and remain.